Hello, welcome back to our module 5, part 4 of our Windows PowerShell Nugget course. So far we have covered Getting Started module 1, Intro module 2, Overview about Objects and Variables, that was module 3, Pipeline and Formatting 4, and then we started with Data Structure, that was 5, and we covered a few sessions, and later on we will do scripting and functions, remoting, WMI, AD, Exchange and SQL. Quick recap, module 5 around writing and formatting output, and we start with the formatting, and then that was first. For today it will be a bit longer because we will talk about using string operators. Let's have a look. Using format operators, string formatting in VPS or VP6 against PowerShell and C#, Java, VP.NET. This is not less code output, but formatting is separated from data. So in total there are three different ways for building a string. You know, either using a script name, and PowerShell has many formatting and output CMD led, but sometimes custom formatting output are needed. Why? To accommodate this PowerShell, you know, provides a format operator similar to C# language implementation. Now hyphen f is the format binary operator, which is really a type of shortcut for string formatting with format bracket static method. It takes the format strings as left and operate and as an array value, and this is you can see the example to reverse the order strings to zero base index. Let me just show you a few of these formatting operators, and you can see the operators, what they mean, starting with display particular elements, and you see the result, display number in hexadecimal, display number in hexadecimal lowercase, uppercase, or number zero justified, or percentage, or currency, or using field with right and time hours format. I'm not going to go through each of these, but however I do have some examples for us. I'm just going to put them here for us, and the first one is around formatting strings examples, and the second one is string again date and time. So I've got two of them which are available through the channel, which you can download it and play with it. This will take care of the basic syntax for using format with index alignment and specific table output. The sample files, you know, read from your C drive folder and just point to the length of each file and generate number, you know, with right aligned for the process, and you can see the output. Okay, next is the formatting. You got these two as a sort of like a lab to get a process of the current PowerShell session and print the output. You can see this current process and ID, and you can see how basic is this to do it in the three way we spoke about earlier, and then you can continue this basically to create file name, length and display name, and read all the files and change the characters and so on to determine the size of it. Next is using split operator. Split string using the given separator, regular expression. It can also use script blocks as a separator. Split operator is one of the more strings, and you can change the element in different options, either using delimiters or maximum number of strings, or option that specify a condition. Also you can use replace and join operator. There is also a replace and join operator to manipulate string. A If the PowerShell does not provide an operator for a certain option, check out the strings class method quotation get member. Also, we have a string for performance. There are many different ways in getting the string from, and the performance can be very different. I've got a test sample. Again, you can use it as a lab for us to be able to test, you know, the join hyphen string ps1. That will show you the performance around, you know, the strings and the building and the monitor side of it. Again, I do have some instruction to create a lab for us here, and you can read the unique value for an event ID 6013, get all the events from the system, and extract only the uptime for all these events, and calculate the average and sum of the uptime and convert it in day and time. You can see the PowerShell associated to achieve this operator. Okay. Now that's all what I had for you for today. Let's we quickly go through this and recap. We started with using format operators, and we said there are three methods to do and achieve that. Then we started with the old method, which is the VP or VPS, and then we spoke about PowerShell and how PowerShell is different, and this is not like a less code, but however, it's the same output, achieve same thing using the same approach we are using with C sharp. And then we move toward using format operators, and we on the table we had list of like 12 or 13 types with expression, and basically result of this expression, like we mentioned, if you wanted the output to be in certain format, ascending, descending, uppercase, lowercase, adjustment. And I show you I've got two sample files with instruction as a lab. I've written them to be utilized if you're gonna be testing, you know, certain operator format. Yeah. And then we move toward the last part, which was using split operator. We said the split operators are a string using given regular expression, and you can use the script blocks as a separator. Then we move toward the replace and join operator. We said there is also a replace and join which manipulate the string, and we said in PowerShell, which does not provide an operator for certain operation, we can use the get member. And then the last part, we spoke about the string performance, and we said there are many different ways in, you know, concatenating the string, and the performance can be very different and similar to the previous one. I've attached a PowerShell script, sample script, which will help us to carry out a task. In this task, it was about capturing and storing the event uptime, which is 6013, and get all the event from the system event log, but only filter for us 6013. Also, it extract only the uptime for all this event, and then it calculate the average and sum of the uptime and convert it into a readable time form, like days, hours, minutes, and so on. And you've seen the PowerShell, also the output underneath it, starting with the Gantt event logs and for each. Now, hopefully you have enjoyed this session, and that was part 4 of module 5. Thank you very much. I shall see you at part 5, which is the last part of module 5, and that should include the formatting. And thank you for watching. Goodbye.